Hello to all viewers. I am KSK, who is a scientific enthusiast, and I welcome you all to MacadoVision channel. In this video, I will tell you about the scientific validity of invisibility. The concept of invisibility has taken over the entertainment industry in the form of movies and books, which has all possible formats for applying the concept of invisibility. Yes, the scientific community has come a great way in realizing the people's dream of invisibility in the society. But whatever is the knowledge regarding the invisibility is kept a secret and is mostly applied to military requirements. Hence, I would now answer the question of common people. Is invisible possible in reality? If possible, what is the scientific rationale behind it? I would try to give a logical answer to all these questions based on scientific knowledge which exists today. I will first define the word invisibility in terms of common sense of understanding. Then I will discuss about the scientific rationale behind the concept of invisibility using few examples. Finally, I will help you to think about the possibility of invisibility based on scientific grounds. As human beings, we can realize the presence of an object based on our senses. That is by using the vision, sound, smell and touch. All these four sources which provide knowledge of the objects is the source to confirm their presence. But by definition, the invisibility is the term mostly associated with the human eye, that is the visual confirmation of the objects. As an example, consider the butterfly in the picture. I can see the butterfly, I can smell the butterfly, I can hear the butterfly flapping the wings. That is an exaggeration for people with very sharp ears to hear butterfly flap its wings. And finally, I can feel the butterfly by holding it in my hand. Now, what the human eye is able to see can be called as universal concept. All the other formats like smell, sound and feeling by senses can be considered as non-universal concept. The other three types of senses are only possible in living things, at least in most cases, which make it more local, that is restricted only to Earth. Until another celestial body with living things having the other three senses is discovered, the smell, sound and feeling by senses come under the category of non-universal concept. In all possibility, whatever the human eye can see is an universal concept, as they are related to electromagnetic radiation. This electromagnetic radiation is present in all corners of this universe. These radiation travel through the entire stretch of the universe as they are reflected, refracted, absorbed and transmitted. All these technical words are related to the motion of light when it is considered as a wave. Hence, we should know the electromagnetic radiation before proceeding with the concept of invisibility. The definition of electromagnetic radiation says that it is a wave which carries forward the energy in x-axis, with electric field in z-axis and magnetic field in y-axis. All the three axes are mutually perpendicular, where the variation in the electric and magnetic field provides a necessary stage for the onward movement of energy. Technically, the energy is associated with the wavelength and the frequency of wave proceeding in x-axis. Finally, in a simple way, electromagnetic radiation is nothing but a traveling energy with wavelength and frequency. As the frequency is more, the energy is more concentrated in the wave. The scientific community has divided the electromagnetic spectrum into different regions and has named them according to their wavelength and frequency. The first region from the left is with very small frequency and large wavelength. The last region at the right is with a very high frequency with small wavelength. The region from the left to right is given as radio waves, microwaves, infrared, visible, ultraviolet, X-rays and gamma ray regions. As common knowledge, we already know that the radios use radio waves and all the modern communication technology including satellite, mobile and wireless communications work using microwaves. With this prior knowledge, we will consider the infrared and visible regions of electromagnetic spectrum. The human eye uses the visible region to see the objects around them. All the cameras, analog and digital, record the visible region for storage and retrieval of content. It is commonly observed that night vision cameras employ the infrared rays for the motion detection in the security and surveillance industry. Hence, if these cameras cannot detect an object using the infrared and visible region of the electromagnetic spectrum, then that object has become simply invisible. But one condition should be remembered always, that the invisibility indicates the ability to be not detected and the object is still present physically. Now, I will take up the example of a peacock and its beautiful appearance. The peacock is a beautiful species with its bounty of colors spread throughout its wings. The wing feathers are special here as they contain the secret for its beautiful existence. The feathers contain special materials for the deflection of light falling on them and produce a beautiful spectrum of colors. Yes, the white light falling on the small scales in the peacock feathers are acting like reflection color centers, which convert white light into beautiful spectrum of colors. When these peacock feathers are kept in the view of an electron microscope, the structure of the feathers show fine scale-like structures, containing patterns repeated in space for effective production of colors. Interestingly, the question arises that how does eye can see those colors? This is a very simple experiment that can be undertaken. The light source produces white light, which consists of all colors of the visible spectrum. Actually, the white light is a composite of all the colors in the VIPGR rainbow colors. Next, the white light falls on the plant leaves, which contain chlorophyll pigments. The work of the plant leaf is to absorb all the colors in the white light except for the green color. Hence, the human eye detects these green light from the leaves and confirms the presence of object visually. This is the way any human eye works, and finally any camera that can work based on the visible spectrum. Here comes the concept of invisibility based on the light waves reaching the human eye. If an imaginary invisibility shield is considered to be present around the leaves, then the work of the shield is to scatter the light coming from the source in all possible directions. This reduces the intensity of light reaching the human eye, which creates the illusion of invisibility. The logical conclusion derived from the above experiment based on the scattering of light is that if light scattered by an object does not reach the eye, then the object becomes invisible. Again, if I take you to the electromagnetic spectrum, you can understand that each spectrum has its own application. Now, application requires that the radiation has to be detected. I'm going to introduce the various types of cameras for different region of electromagnetic spectrum. Here, for radiations, the camera are even known as detectors and antennas. To start with, the visible spectrum can be recorded using the ordinary analog and digital cameras. The infrared cameras are the analog used in night vision detection cameras. The ultraviolet cameras use the detection of UV rays emitted by an object to detect its presence. The radio waves and microwaves are detected using the radio towers and microwave antennas respectively. Finally, the X-rays and gamma rays, which are highly ionizing radiations with very high energies, are detected using specially made detectors. You may wonder why I am discussing these concepts at this point. Yes, you are absolutely correct. I am going to discuss the already existing technology of invisibility, or otherwise known as stealth mode. At some point in your life, you must have heard of radar, which is used in military and aviation industries to detect, calculate the range and identify the flying objects. Similarly, the ships and submarines in the world use the technique of sonar for the underwater ranging and detection of ocean waters. Finally, the latest but less common technology is the LIDAR, which uses the laser to detect the range of objects. Now, particularly in radar technology, all the flying objects are detectable as they reflect back the microwaves and register their presence. But there are stealth mode aircraft bombers in few militaries around the world which are not detected by these radars. Practically, these stealth mode aircraft bombers are invisible to radars. They can easily target their enemy boundaries without being detected. What makes these aircraft invisible? Yes, these aircrafts are made of special materials. I can say a kind of invisible shield that scatter the microwaves coming from the radar. When no signal is returned back to the radar from the aircraft, then it is practically invisible. Here, I want to register that invisibility is possible if one can scatter all the light falling on an object. You must be thinking now, why I have shown almost invisible text in the screen now? Yes, to make you feel for the next possible way to attain invisibility. One can visually blend with the background and become invisible. How is that possible? Nature has shown answer for this. This is also called camouflage. The chameleon camouflages its skin to match the environment around and then becomes almost invisible. This technique also can be used to become invisible from the eye of the enemy. Now, it's time to discuss about the possibility of invisibility. Yes, scientifically, the concept of invisibility is possible using different ideas. One is the scattering of light falling on an object using an invisibility shield. Another is the visual blending of the object with the background for invisibility. Yes, in this video, the concept of invisibility is scientifically proven now. But how this is done? What are the materials used for such a concept? Already the technology is available for military. And there are many such questions that I have reserved for the next video in the series on invisibility. I hope that you all enjoyed this video. I thank you all for watching this video. See you in next video.